Hello everybody, my name is Ash. Welcome back to Andromeda. Just gotta continue on with the talky talks. This ain't gonna be a proper session because I have to go to sleep soon for work. So we're just gonna do like the whole talky talk and get ourselves set up somewhat for the first planet that we visit. Let's talk to you, Kiesh.
Yes, I'm... There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
Tan, ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the initiative.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the initiative, Jean Garson, was killed.
What happened to Jean Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders. Tan might know more.
But I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with the Genophage.
Right. The Genophage. A little gift to our people from the Salarians thousands of years ago. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survived.
No wonder your people have such a problem with Salarians.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Salarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Salarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about new beginnings. My people need that more than most.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show mutation against the virus. A natural defense. During the trip to get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. Still early, but I think we made a dent. Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%. Which is a lot better than what we had. Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place. I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible, considering.
Nothing more for now.
See you later.
Okay, so spot to Kiesh. Same shit, different day. Alright. Speak to Sam on Hyperion. Yeah, no, pass. Pass. Why have you got a gun out for? You know something I don't? Alright. Now let's go talk to our boy, Kandros.
results. Though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know? Then my sister became a sculptor, and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that I stayed in service.
Ah, Nyrene, she's in Mass Effect 3.
Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our Ark mission.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
It's rough out there. I might need backup, if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
And that's the multiplayer, which I'm very familiar with.
Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
You know, maybe I'll throw in some multiplayer video episodes.
Reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization to participate. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization.
That's the console for our strike team.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex, combat experts who've signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
I'll deploy your people carefully, Kandros.
Appreciate that, Ryder. But trust me, Apex can handle themselves. Authorization complete. Good luck out there.
So, yeah, as you see here, we've got our strike teams and some of these are for multiplayer. I know what to do. I've got these two ready because these are from like a while ago as well. So like, you know, maybe I'll get them, maybe I won't. But point is, you get items for campaign as well as like extra XP and stuff, mission funds. I don't need that because I've maxed out the manifest. Pathfinder rewards, gold credit box and thing and what have you. So what we're going to get, oh, these are strike teams, don't really care about that stuff. So what we're going to get out of these boxes will decide what we're going to have as a build. So let's just claim all rewards, which takes a bit of time. But yeah, I might actually throw in a few multiplayer matches for strike team just to break up the monotony. Because I do enjoy this game quite a bit. I do enjoy the multiplayer quite a bit as well. No! Whatever. So we get like claim rewards, element zero, and credits. Now we're going to have a lot of pop-ups at the side there. But if we look at our thing, look at that. We've got a shitload of quite a good bit of credits. Armor, initiative armor, initiative armor, very bog standard. Chest piece. Anyway, the weapons, let's have a look. Pistols, Eagle, Boo, Hurricane, very good. Hurricane is the is probably the pistol I'd probably lean towards. But of course, we'd like to have a higher rank. We don't have a paw, maybe I have to discover that. Riga is also very good, but it's pretty heavy. I have a Black Widow. Go and infiltrate. Do an infiltrator. Vanquish is actually good. The decisions. The decisions. I do like the Vanquisher though. But I'll decide all this off camera. And also resources and stuff. We'll go into that later.
Exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda. But the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have. There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Alright. And she looks she looks like fucking snot slapped on a fucking plum. Gross. Oh, it's Liam.
Pathfinder. No time for our beer yet. This place is a mess. Security is... Let's call it straight.
I can believe it. The Nexus is running on empty.
Not just that. A lot of the exiles were security. Everyone was trained and armed for Frontier. We know Kett are dangerous, and now we have to worry about our people too. No idea where they went, but they left mad.
There's apparently no viable planets in range. Exile may have been a sanitized death sentence.
What a shit show. Pathfinder, we have to get this back on track or we don't survive. No pressure, right?
As long as the Nexus is here, as long as we're here, we have a job to do.
Double down crisis mode. I can do that. We can do that. Ready and willing, Pathfinder.
That stupid hood that he's wearing.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
What fields do you study?
Herrick's in the life sciences. I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math whiz.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Ooh, skill up.
Pathfinder, we've had some trouble.
Anything I can help with?
Perhaps. I discharged an away team to get readings from a section of the Scourge that was behaving anomalously. They haven't reported in for some time, and sensors can't locate their shuttle. I sent them out there. Good, dedicated people. I fear what might have happened to them.
Your work is important. Don't lose sight of that. When I'm out there, I'll see if I can find them.
Their friends and family will want to know what's happened. And I need to know.
Hi, Pathfinder. Want to hit some rocks for science?
Absolutely. What do you need?
Sam and I used your scans and made a VI for geophysics surveys. Beta builds on the console. Test it out in the field, and I'll wrangle you a consultant's bonus from Director Addison. How's that sound?
Sounds good. Scan for rocks.
Pathfinder, those bioscans are superb. Could you gather more for our comparative conservation effort?
What conservation effort?
Ah, my thesis is on the console there. Broad strokes, we're comparing and preserving organisms from both galaxies. If you donate more bioscans and samples to the catalog, I can get you a finder's fee. Tempted?
Sounds good to me. I can do with more XP and what have you. Okay, activate and activate. Good shit, add that. Just keep adding the quests, that's what we're here for.
Help you.
Pathfinder Rider, here's the
help you.
Ah, a murderer. Wife's here all the time. Guess she told you a sob story. Milka, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanted to chat with you.
Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
I'm not here to exile you. Told your wife I'd look into things.
At this point, it's too late. They found me guilty.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend. He refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
So when he was killed, people assumed you did it?
For good reason. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and I guess I panicked and fired. A witness saw the chief's chest explode.
Sounds like an accident.
That's what I told them. But I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
I'll check out the evidence. Maybe something doesn't add up.
And it'd be nice to have someone with an open mind looking at it. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Console to take a look through what I got.
Nice eyebrows.
If I weren't missing half my stock.
Ouch. Why am I paying for these?
Half the supplies are inaccessible, what with how we crash landed and all. And I have to trade with the crooks out there for the rest, so.
And he sells pretty much fuck all. Junk. But we'll sell. Be sure to sell to him at some point. Said, not decided what I want to do with my character builds yet. That's where we need to go, isn't it? Speak to Sam and Hyperion. Yeah, no. Trying to think, where else do we go? Oh yeah, let's go back to Kandros to speak to them.
Spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos?
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help the spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
So there was a trial, and he was found guilty?
It was short and decisive. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
That is... is the difference between murder and accidental death.
In this case, motive plus opportunity plus eyewitness account equals murder. Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you cue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder. The Nexus versus Colonist Milken, Evidence 7A.
Hiram! Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Milken. We're taking it back.
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to...
No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Oh, it's Kara.
Hey there.
You okay? Those guys really grilled you. And Addison. First Pathfinder they've seen in over a year. All she can do is question your competence?
Which one was Addison again? All politicians look the same to me.
Same here. Next time we'll ask for a seating chart. I worked out logistics with Director Tan. They're giving us a ship and crew. He said their best is taking care of it.
I still need to head back to the Ark and check in with Sam.
Sounds good. While you're there, maybe see how your sister's doing.
Alrighty then. Speak to old Sammy boy.
Hello, Scott. Welcome back to Sam Mood. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best to speak alone.
I don't understand the need for secrecy.
Your father felt it was for the best.
What was he trying to hide?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's... me, now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient, far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
But the human's still in charge, right?
Of course. I was never intended to supplant the Pathfinder, only to support and enhance your abilities.
Good to hear. So what's the plan?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
So yeah, profiles. So we get more goodies if we obviously that's the only one we have because we've got a very meager ability. But yeah, profiles. Not so there's no real class system in this game, but if we level up certain skill points, we're gonna get more in those areas. So like infiltrator, you know, like free skills in combat and tech. Get like the weapon stability, tech recharge, and headshot damage stuff. Sentinels, you know, a bit of tech, a bit of biotics, not too bad. Should recharge cost, you know. This one here, Explorer, where it's like a jack of all trades thing, where it's like weapon and damage resistance. I don't know which one will be better suited to us. Adept, Spartic Force, Area. A lot of good stuff. Engineer, combo, damage, tech, construct. I don't even know about constructs. It's hard to say. Maybe Sentinel might be a good idea. Tech recharge, power shield. I don't know. I'm kind of torn. I don't know what I'm gonna do yet. I've got 6 skill points to play around with as well. But yeah, we kind of have to build towards a class. Oh, thanks. Sidearm.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy.
Normandy.
Crazy time. Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger, related to your father, and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Sam Node on the Hyperion to investigate further.
Alright. I like how he's got like a can of beans like just sat there. Oh, I can aim. I can zoom in. That's pretty cool.
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like. What's on here, Sam?
Your father's personal logs. Several of them are encrypted.
Oh, Liara.
Sam, this is a reminder about Dr. Liara Tassoni. She's an Asari archaeologist I corresponded with a few years back. She's got experience studying ancient cultures. Make sure the team gets her research. Could be useful in Andromeda.
Pretty sure my sister's mentioned Dr. Tassoni. An expert on Protheans, I think.
I have loaded Dr. Tassoni's research onto data pads.
Jesus, what is that text-to-speech voice acting? Fuck me. Did they even get the actress who plays her to fucking do a readout? Like, that's terrible.
Hello, Alec. I received your message. I must say, the thought of exploring another galaxy has my head spinning. I am honestly not sure how people could survive a trip like that. And anyway, I could not bear to leave the Milky Way behind. There is so much about the Protheans I still hope to learn here. So much potential wisdom to tap. I wish you much good luck and future success.
catalog is not currently accessible. Unlocking my memory array may enable it.
I am Dr. Liara Tassoni, and I've spent several decades researching ancient Protheans. It is common knowledge that the Protheans were an advanced race that flourished in the Milky Way about 50,000 years ago, then went extinct. Even at the time of this writing, the year 2182, their culture remains a mystery. During my studies, I have developed some practices that can be used when analyzing any ancient culture. I hope they may prove useful for the research community. I am Dr. Liara Tassoni.
Okay, whatever. Same shit, different. Alright, wait, is that another really? Books.
Printed books.
Reproductions of Lewis and Clark's journals, detailing their expedition in the 19th century.
Explains Dad's interest. They were pathfinders too.
Alright, let's go to Sam Nord and see if we can get like that some of them more of them things done up.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day. Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
An AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive. But an AI? And
how?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
Wow. Hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
It's how Dad was wired. He didn't like to lose, in any situation.
It would seem that included me.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it. I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. This is where my core processing unit resides. However, using quantum entanglement communication, I remain in constant touch with you and the Pathfinder mission team, even over great distances.
What more can you tell me about my implant?
The implant itself provides me with direct access to your senses. I can see, hear, and experience the same stimuli you do while in the field. This raw data enables me to provide real-time feedback and analysis of the situation.
Then Dad added the secret sauce.
You removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Just promise you won't fry my brain or anything.
Trust is an important concept in any relationship. Alec taught me that. I will not fry your brain. It would end badly for both of us.
Me more than you. Do you know anything more about Sarah's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing her with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
What are your capabilities?
Each arc houses a SAM, simulated, adaptive, matrix. Each is an artificial intelligence designed by Alec Ryder to support Pathfinders and their teams.
But AI is illegal in the Milky Way. How'd my dad get around that?
Exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was conducted in secret.
So there are other SAMs out there?
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced SAM in the initiative.
Alright, so if we come across any Pathfinders, they're not going to be all gimmicked up like us.
What did you mean by a symbiotic relationship?
Symbiosis is a mutually beneficial relationship between two life forms. A flower provides nectar to a bee, who in turn provides pollen for the flower. The bee gains nourishment, and the flower can propagate. In similar fashion, my own evolution was shaped by your father's experiences, and will now expand with yours. In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis beyond normal human faculties. You each benefit.
That's all for now.
Of course. Father's personal logs.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
That log is not currently accessible. Unlocking my memory array may enable it.
All right. What's that Z doing?
Pathfinder, good to see you. Word is there's been trouble on the station.
We just got here. How did you know that already?
Word gets around.
Does it now?
People talk to me? Anyway, as soon as we establish outposts, everything will even out. I'm sure of it.
What about your family?
I'm an orphan. My parents died on the Mindoir colony when it was attacked years ago. No siblings. I left some friends and distant relatives behind. But I have friends here too. I love piloting. But I like the idea of going back to my roots, farming like my parents did. Someday.
Why did you join the initiative?
The most popular question on the station. Honestly, I wouldn't have known about this project if Nozomi hadn't reached out to me.
Nozomi?
Captain Dunn. Of all the captains I've piloted for, she's the best. I've always been a wanderer at heart. When she asked me to be her pilot, how could I say no to the adventure of a lifetime?
How do you feel about all this now that we're here?
Hopeful. I know it's a rose-colored outlook, but someone's got to keep the positivity coming, right?
Have to go now. See you later.
Talk to you later.
Ryder.
You're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy. Though Cryo Bay and Sam Note are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alec's quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey, sorry about your father. He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people. He was right about going planetside, though.
As long as they did their jobs, he didn't care what people thought of him.
I noticed that. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
Now that the Hyperion is docked, what'll you do?
Normally, I'd supervise thawing out the colonists, but that's been put on hold. I hear you're the one helping resolve the issue. Good luck with that.
If someone had told you that you'd be in the Andromeda Cluster, even 5 years ago...
Are you kidding me? I'd have laughed them out of the quadrant. Although, the way things are now isn't exactly what I was hoping for, either. We all knew there was a possibility on arrival of less than ideal circumstances. When you sign up, you hope for the best, and plan for the worst.
Why did you join the Initiative? We're a long way from home.
How could I not? I love my job. Coming here, all this, it was just a logical extension of what I already do. Sailing through new stars, discovering new worlds. What self-respecting explorer could pass that up?
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
All right. Where's the fucking med bay so I can visit Miss Sister? Is it this room? No. Atrium. How's this? Containers? Yeah, sure. I'll loot people's stuff. I don't give a shit. It don't belong to me. Cryo bay. Oh, cryo bay. That's where we want to go. Meow.
Sacrifice won't be forgotten.
Agreed. Everything I do will be for him. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
Alright, that's a little side quest we get. Nice.
Fisher. Glad to see you're doing better.
That was some expedition, hey? Captain said I'm going in the log as the first human to make contact with the Ket. And Kirkland's the first casualty. Wish it could have gone differently.
Wasn't your fault. It's obvious the Ket aren't friendly. Nothing we did could have changed that.
I suppose you're right. It's just not what you dream about. Meet a new species and 3 seconds later they're trying to kill you.
I hear you. But I guess that's life. Not everyone will see things our way. In the meantime, chin up. It'll get better.
Ryder, good to see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I haven't heard how he died.
Like a hero. That's how. That's the only part that matters. I've met one path. I figure that's the way to go, taking your last breath on an uncharted world.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Now I just need to make sure your sister here pulls through.
Are you staying here on the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning in the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
What will you do on the Hyperion?
We still have thousands of people taking a nap here, and they need tending to. And this way I can look out for Sarah.
How's Sarah doing?
Her condition's stable. I
see signs of REM activity in the brain, so she's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another rider.
How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
Ryder.
Hayes, how's the wound?
Doc says I'll live. So this goes from a life-threatening gunshot to a story I'll tell my grandkids someday.
With no need to exaggerate. That was a tough fight on Habitat 7.
Just glad to be on the other side of it.
Greer, how you feeling?
Grateful. If you and Liam hadn't found me in that cave, God knows what those aliens would have done.
We couldn't leave a man behind.
Yeah, your father, Kirkland.
I know. It's rough. Being on the Pathfinder team is turning out to be a dangerous business.
More than I ever thought. I'm sorry I'm not out there with you, but Kirkland was a friend. And I'm not cut out for this anymore.
Understood. Habitat 7 was a nasty wake-up call. You take care, Greer.
You too. Thanks again.
Anybody else out here? Information wall? Yeah, I'll pass on that. Let's go back to our ship. I'll go to our ship. We have a ship now, but we haven't seen it yet. Hibernation deck operations, which is where the all the idiots are.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen.
Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
I didn't realize I had the frame rate counter up in the top corner. Whatevs.
Everything state of the art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Glad to see you're doing so well, Scott.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
Every plan the Initiative made is out the window. Now it's on us to find the way.
We all came here ready for a challenge. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
There we go, and that...
Head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
And I think I'll end the episode there, because good lord, we went on a bit there. Save the game. Yeah, that's going to be a long episode. And we're going to do a fucking Tempest episode after this. So, very dialogue heavy, very blah, 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 you know? So, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And I'm going to look into some of these abilities, see what we get. Because tech, you know, a lot of useful stuff. I'm very tempted to go with energy drain just for survivability's sake. But yeah, I do want to play a Biotic as well, but we're playing on Hardcore, so maybe playing with a... I mean, to be fair, with this profile things, we might get a bit, like, depending on how quick we level up, we can switch between, like, Biotics and tech and what have you, like, whenever we want, so that'll be interesting. Yeah, well, we'll see what happens. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.